edition of Rajneeti, Policy and Politics. Welcome, Siddharth, and thank you so much for taking time for this special second edition of Rajneeti.
Thank you so much.
All our audiences loved the first episode. We've had a resounding response. Everybody loved the way you explained to them the intricacies of what really happened in the GST Council meeting. But today, we are going one step beyond policy and politics and also discussing what is really going around in the corporate world.
Absolutely, and that's a good point, but we'll also, viewers today, take the corporate story that Sakshi is hinting and a small surprise from me. Yeah. We're also going to discuss what's happening with regard to the story that you must have seen about a Canadian court ordering the seizure of assets of Air India and the Airports Authority of India. But Sakshi, over to you.
Let's actually begin by the corporate story, which is actually making a lot of headlines right now. And that is that all is not well in perhaps the largest two-wheeler company or the group, Hero MotoCorp and Hero Electric. There is perhaps a spat brewing between the Munjal family, Pavan Munjal of Hero MotoCorp, and his nephew, Naveen Munjal of Hero Electric. I wanted to understand from you, what exactly is the current situation? Why this spat over electric vehicles in this entire group?
Well, very clearly, it boils down to a family agreement where the ownership within the Hero Group was restructured. Now, the Hero Group, a famous group by all reckoning, one of the oldest industrial giants in the country, a manufacturing company, a company founded by people who had to sort of leave that part of India, which later on became Pakistan and suffered a lot of economic difficulties as a result. And it's a great story of Indian entrepreneurship. We know that the Munjal Group ownership was restructured, and the dramatis personae, really, as Sakshi was saying, in this entire episode is Pavan Munjal, which is one part of the separate entities, the separate group, and the other is the OP Munjal family. Now, the family agreement in 2010, and it was like any big Hindu undivided family in a way at that point of time. The four brothers, those who were the founders of the Hero Group, decided to go their own separate ways, and different lines of business were carved out. Now, in this case, the contention of Naveen Munjal and that part of the group is that as far as the brand Hero Electric is concerned, that brand Hero Electric will remain only for their exclusive use, obviously for electric vehicles. Now, on the other side, we know that Pavan Munjal has big plans for the electric vehicle space. He's spoken in the past about a decade-long roadmap for this space and putting in a lot of money. And also, he has mentioned that this is very important because the Hero Group has a very significant global footprint, Sakshi, that we will manufacture these electric vehicles, two-wheelers really, because it's predominantly a two-wheeler company, and export them all over the world, specifically in 20 geographies, 20 export markets where Hero products are already sold. So that's the backdrop. Now, what is interesting here is that over the past couple of years, when the first news started coming out of this brand separation and the electric vehicle space, Sakshi, started to heat up. So suddenly something that did not seem as valuable in 2010, and I think this is the lesson for business case studies, really, in some way, that no one thought that the electric mobility, electric vehicle, electric two-wheeler, electric car segment would become the hottest segment, and you know, the market cap of several of these firms is bigger than the oldest and the biggest and the most established automobile companies. No one knew. So it's basically a fight over a brand which emanates from the sudden emergence or rather unexpected emergence from that family agreement of 2010 perspective of the electric mobility space, Sakshi.
But I wanted to understand from you, Siddharth, that wasn't there any non-compete clause that was signed between the brothers back then?
That's a very, very important question. And as per the reports, previous and new reports, and I must tell our viewers that we are still awaiting formal statements from all those involved. What we know for a fact is that this matter is now in the Delhi High Court. There are news reports to that effect, and a hearing on that is scheduled very shortly. We'll get more details from there, but from past remarks, it's clear that there is no non-compete, which means that the Pawan Munjal Hero Moto Corp group is free to venture into the electric two-wheeler space. The dispute is on the use of the brand name. As far as Hero Moto Corp is concerned, it isn't clear, it's a bit of a tight-lipped matter, whether the products that they intend to launch, and that launch is expected from previous reports in March of this year, March 2022, we don't know whether the intention is to use the Hero branding for that. That bit is fuzzy. It's not clear at this stage, I must caution. But given that there's a dispute, and given that Naveen Munjal has approached the Delhi High Court seeking an injunction, that means there must be something behind the scenes. From a news perspective, it's clear that the court hearing will provide us details of what is going on. But it's a very interesting story. You know, it's a story about business. It's a story about the history of the subcontinent.
Absolutely.
The pains of partition, the development of a business, two-wheelers, affordable, long mileage two-wheelers, which revolutionized public transport,
Absolutely.
Private transport in this country. So it's a storied brand, the Hero brand, and there's a side story on the Hero group. Incidentally, I just interviewed was on a panel discussion recently with Sunil Munjal, and he has written a book where he gives out a story about how the Hero brand was acquired. It's fascinating.
Okay.
So hopefully this is something that will get sorted out soon, Sakshi, and the bottom line is that with most automakers chasing the electric opportunity, hopefully both of them will be also able to do whatever they plan to do.
Yes, absolutely. We'll have to just wait to find out whether the legal tussle will get murkier from here on, or will there be an easy solution to this entire spat that we are seeing. Will Hero Moto Corp be okay to drop the name Hero Moto Corp from its upcoming electric vehicle venture? All of these questions are still hanging, and we'll have to wait for all the developments. But just like how you said, you have a surprise for us.
Well, I just thought, since it's Rajniti, let's quickly dive into the whole Davis Multimedia Air India Airport Authority of India news that's been doing the rounds for a day now. The news element really is that Davis Multimedia has managed to get a $30 million seizure order for assets that belong to the Airports Authority of India and Air India. This is an order basis a Canadian court. Now, the backstory is very fascinating, and I'll quickly sort of give a recap of that. In 2005, the commercial arm of ISRO, Indian Space Research Organization, a company, corporation, an entity which all Indians are proud of. It's a global leader, it's a technology leader, and it has a commercial arm called Antrix, which signed an agreement with a company called Davis Multimedia, which had a lot of foreign funding as well, to offer satellite broadband services.
Okay.
In 2011, after the famous CAG report of telecom spectrum, the allegations, that deal was cancelled by the UPA.
Okay.
And ever since, Davis shareholders have been chasing the sovereign, the government of India, for compensation. There are two awards, arbitration awards, that have gone in their favor.
Okay.
And meanwhile, the company was ordered to be liquidated by the NCLT, which is also in the Supreme Court. So, minus all of this, it is something that has become a bit of a legal challenge for the government of India. Remember, the government of India has settled with Cain. But this is a matter which is still pending. Again, the government of India has approached a superior court in Canada. We will see what happens there. But just that it's a legacy of all the economic mismanagement that happened during a particular era,
yeah.
which is now coming and foxing the Modi government in some.
At a time when Tata Sons is going to be taking over.
Yeah, and that's a very important point. Actually, very quickly, I'll say this is very important what you have said. Several people have asked this question.
Yeah.
Will this impact the Tata takeover of Air India?
Yeah.
No, because the agreement between the Tatas and the government of India for the Air India takeover, that agreement is going to be signed hopefully within this month of January.
Okay.
That agreement makes it very clear. All past liabilities, legal issues are the responsibility of the government and not of the Tatas.
So that's great news for Tata Sons then. Thank you so much, Siddharth, for sharing these insights.
Thank you very much.
On these two very important news bits. And we'll keep getting you such interesting insights on the world, in the world of news, on Business Today. So do stay tuned with us. Do like and subscribe to our YouTube channel, both in English and in Hindi on Business Today, as well as stay connected with us through all our social media platforms, Twitter, LinkedIn, Facebook and Instagram. Thanks a lot for tuning in.
Thank you.